Did you know that the proof of the Big Bang Theory was discovered by accident? This is a story of a CUNY graduate who became a Nobel Laureate and the discovery of cosmic microwave background.
Billions of years ago, all the matter of the universe, a compressed, hot, dense, primordial energy soup, exploded.
Throughout history, there have been hundreds of origin myths for our universe. Flying horses, massive chaotic oceans, gods at war, turtles and elephants carrying the world, etc. By the early 20th century, these myths gave way to a single cosmological assumption. The universe was expanding. What the scientists could not agree upon, however, was why. Two competing theories emerged. The steady-state theory proposed that although the universe was expanding, it was also generating new matter constantly. This was an eternal universe without an end and without a beginning. The second theory asserted that the universe was expanding but was also finite. Such a universe could logically be traced back in time to a single point in space and a moment of creation. A very violent moment, the Big Bang. When Arno Penzias was born, the world was heading for another violent moment. Just a couple of months before the start of World War II, a 6-year-old Arno and his younger brother Gunther were evacuated from Germany as part of the Kinder Transport rescue operation. Unlike many other Jewish children rescued in this effort, the two brothers were fortunate enough to be reunited with their family.
In 1940, the family moved to New York.
Arno's mother took a job in a sewing factory and his father as a carpenter, but it was always their dream to send their children to college. College, he wrote later on, meant City College of New York, a municipally supported institution then beginning its second century of moving the children of New York's immigrant poor into the American middle class. It was here at CUNY City College that Arno developed his interest in physics. Originally enrolled as a chemistry student, he soon changed majors and in 1954, earned a degree in physics, ranked near the top of his class.
In 1961, Penzias took a job doing research at Bell Labs in Holmdel, New Jersey. The company had just constructed a 20-foot horn reflector antenna with a state-of-the-art receiver to communicate with commercial satellites. 2 years later, however, the antenna became commercially redundant, and Penzias, along with his research partner Robert Wilson, was free to use it for scientific research. The two astronomers began planning a series of listening experiments. Their objective? To detect, measure, and interpret radio waves coming from the universe. It was for this purpose that Penzias built his helium-cooled reference noise source, a device specifically designed to eliminate any possible interference and allow an undisturbed look at the mysteries of the universe. The universe, however, had other plans. The first measurement came as a big disappointment. On their initial reading, Penzias and Wilson noticed an extra 3.5 Kelvin antenna temperature that they could not explain. To their great dismay, all of the following tests gave the same result. The excess noise was persistent and its temperature constant regardless of the direction in which the antenna was pointing. For the next 9 months, they tried to eliminate all possible sources of the annoying interference. The Milky Way, nuclear testing, man-made noise, New York City, even pigeon droppings in the antenna were considered, but eventually dismissed. Soon it became evident that this mysterious sound had a much bigger source. Some 30 miles away in Princeton, New Jersey, Robert Dickey and his team of cosmologists were working on an antenna of their own, one that would search for the proof of the Big Bang Theory. If their predictions were right, over a period of billions of years, the heat generated during the Big Bang would cool down and turn into something called cosmic background radiation. This remnant of the greatest explosion of all time would by now be discernible only in the form of radio microwaves, energy detectable only with the most sophisticated equipment. While talking to a former colleague from MIT, Penzias learned about Dickey's efforts to find this proof of the Big Bang. The description of relic radiation sounded surprisingly similar to the cosmic hiss he and Wilson encountered on their antenna at Bell Laboratories. In an instant, the magnitude and significance of his discovery became clear. Penzias decided to reach out. In 1965, Arno Penzias and Robert Wilson published their discovery in the Astrophysical Journal alongside Robert Dickey's letter on background radiation. The impact on the scientific community was huge. Almost immediately, the steady-state theory was abandoned to give way to a more accurate and complete understanding of the universe. The Big Bang theory had won. Arno Penzias and Robert Wilson received the Nobel Prize for Physics in 1978. The radio antenna that they used for their discovery was designated a national landmark in 1988. But you don't have to go to New Jersey to experience a bit of this monumental discovery. Because about 1% of the white noise you can hear on any old TV or radio receiver comes from that cosmic microwave background that Penzias discovered more than 50 years ago. It is a faint wisp of heat from that massive explosion 13.8 billion years ago, picked up by your TV and converted into noise. It is the sound of creation.